Hi, I'm Steve with Making at Home. Today I'm going to show you how I built this animated movie poster using an Arduino board and a ton of LEDs. I started out by taking a black and white copy of the poster and cutting it out so I could use it as a template for all the LEDs. I had some acrylic sheets cut for the front of the poster frame. So then I took this and used it to cut out a piece of matching plywood. I sanded this plywood smooth, and then I used spray adhesive on the black and white copy of the poster to attach it to the plywood. I used this as a guide to lay out all the LED strips for the animation on the poster. Before I got too far into the woodworking, I started programming the Arduino to make sure I could get the LED lights to do what I wanted. This included figuring out the spacing between the LED strips and the poster so I didn't have hot spots on the display. Next came the long process of laying out the LED strips over the poster. This involved screwing the LED strips to the backer board and also soldering all the connections for the power, the ground, and the control wire to all the LED strips. Once I had all of the LEDs in place, I could really see what the poster was going to look like with the animation effects. Here's a look at the LEDs lighting up through initial tests. This gives you an idea of what it looks like before it goes into the poster frame. I went back to working on the poster frame, and I decided to use dovetail joints for all the corners. You could really make the corners any way you want, but I had the dovetail jig, so I decided to use that. Working on the frame, I made sure that my measurements were right so that the backer board that had the poster on it would fit inside the frame easily. That was one piece I did not want to have to recut or resize. Before I glued the frame together, I decided it would be easier to make all the exterior holes in the frame. This included drilling 3 holes for the arcade buttons in the top of the frame, and also adding a couple holes in the bottom of the frame for the motion sensor and the power supply. For the power supply opening, I just drilled a couple holes and then used a jigsaw to take out the rest of the material. For the motion sensor, I decided to drill a hole at about a 45 degree angle so that the motion sensor would detect movement in front of the poster. I did this by using a Craig pocket hole drill bit, and then I used a file and some sanding paper to smooth out the edges of the hole. I cut out some additional material on the backside of the frame for the motion sensor itself. With all of the holes cut and drilled in the outside frame, now I could glue everything together. I took my time to make sure everything lined up properly before I put the glue on the joints. I made sure that all the dovetail joints were fully inserted into the matching piece. In order to make sure that the frame would match the backer board, I just inserted the backer board with the poster on it into the glue up. The clear acrylic pieces that actually hold the poster in place are held in the frame with retaining pieces that run around the outside of the front of the frame. These are just matching pieces of poplar that are 3/8 of an inch wide that run around the outside of the frame. I glued the retaining strips on the sides of the poster frame first. Then I measured and cut and glued the pieces on the top and the bottom. This way I got an exact match. Make sure that when you glue the retaining strips in place that you have them flush with the front of the poster frame. This will help it look more uniform and make the finishing much easier. With the frame all glued, now we can take all the clamps off and sand everything down so we can get it ready to take the stain and the finish. I used a black gel stain on the frame, and I ended up having to put 2 coats on to get it completely black. Even then, when I got done, I found a couple spots that were a little light. I decided to leave these just because I thought it added a little character to the frame. The gel stain took a little while to dry, so I could only put on 1 coat per day. The final finish I put on the frame was a oil and urethane finish that was diluted 50-50 with mineral spirits. I then cut spacer pieces to go around the inside of the frame. These pieces space the acrylic on the front of the poster to the backer board on the back of the poster. Next, I cut the cleats, which involved cutting the pieces of plywood at 45 degrees on the table saw. Next, I took the spacer pieces and laid them around the inside of the poster frame. I had to cut some of the areas out to make room for the arcade buttons on the top and the power and the motion sensor on the bottom. Once I had all the spacer pieces cut to size, I then laid them out on the inside of the frame on top of a playing card. This way, when I screwed them into the side of the frame, I had a snug fit once the card was removed. Next, I started making room for the components inside the poster frame. I only had an inch between the back of the acrylic and the backer board with the LEDs mounted to it. So I actually cut a part of the backer board out so I could lower the Arduino board inside the frame. I used a jigsaw to cut a section of the backer board out. Then I mounted another small piece of plywood to the back of the backer board that the Arduino could be attached to. I also had the same clearance issue with the power supply. The power supply was actually thicker than the room I had between the backer board and the back of the acrylic. So I cut a section out of the backer board by drilling four holes and then cutting between the holes with a jigsaw. I then used some metal strapping material to secure the power supply in this opening. This worked really well and held the power supply away from the plywood and gave it a little more airflow. I then routed all the electrical and the control wires on the poster frame. On some of the wires I used retaining clips, and on others I used a small dab of hot glue. I cut some small plastic tubing and used those small pieces as standoffs for the Arduino board and the mounting board it was attached to. I realized later that the Arduino Uno was too small for all the programming memory, so I actually ended up replacing it with an Arduino Mega. This had a lot more memory and it actually fit in the same area that the Uno did. I even used the same standoffs. Wiring the buttons on the top of the frame was a little more challenging. I actually had to route the wiring down the inside of the frame to the bottom where the hinges are mounted. With all of the wiring completed, I turned the poster frame over and actually screwed the backer board into the spacers. The spacer pieces are actually attached to the sides of the poster frame and they tie everything together. At this point, I had the entire frame assembled with power and all the controls working. Now I had to focus on the programming. This was a very time-consuming process since this was my first Arduino project. I used a lot of the example on the Adafruit website. They have a lot of great information there. Because of the way I programmed the Arduino, I actually used a spreadsheet in order to combine the different columns for each pixel or each LED. The columns represented the green, red, blue, and white portions of the LED. I basically ended up creating a storyboard for the animation effects. I decided what would happen for each LED for every section of the storyline. Then I assigned a time frame from when that pixel or LED would be updated. And once I had all of these created, I put them all into one spreadsheet and sorted them by the time at which those updates were to happen. I think trying to do all of this programming within the Arduino text editor would have been nearly impossible without keeping things separated in the spreadsheet. With all of the programming done, now it was time to hang the poster. I marked all of the locations of the studs in the wall using blue painter's tape. I attached the mounting cleat to the wall using a level to make sure that when I hung the poster it would be straight. I'm not sure how heavy the whole poster assembly is. It seemed fairly heavy, probably over 20 pounds, so I ended up using 3-inch deck screws to attach the mounting cleat to the wall. I really didn't want to take a chance at this point of everything falling off the wall and getting damaged. So let me explain how the animated movie poster works. There's actually a motion sensor in the bottom of the frame, so that when you walk by, it turns on the lightsabers, then the credits, Star Wars fades in, The Force Awakens fades in from the center out, Then some other effects turn on, including TIE fighters shooting at the Millennium Falcon. Now it stays on for a certain length of time, and then it fades out and turns things off in the same order that they were turned on. If you want this to stay on all the time like this, you can hit the left button and go to mode 2. Flashes twice, let you know that's the mode you're in, and then those LED lights and those patterns turn on and stay on until you change it. Now, if you want something a little different, not quite as distracting, you can go to mode 3, and that's a motion sensor mode just for white LEDs to turn on in the back. That'll stay on for a certain length of time and then turns off, just like the other motion sensor mode. You can hit it one more time to go to mode 4, and this is where the LEDs are on full white the whole time. Now you can change the brightness setting by hitting the middle button, and then the LEDs are updated in real time. So if you don't want something quite as bright for like in a room when it's kind of dark, or in a movie room, you could do this. And then you can cycle that to just go up to the other brightness levels and back to full white. If you want something different, you can go to the next mode, which is just the lightsabers turning on with the motion sensor. So those will come on just like you saw in the first mode. They'll stay on for a certain length of time and then turn off. You can go to the next mode, which is just those two lightsabers on all the time. And then for something really different, you can go to the next mode, which is a motion sensor mode where the lightsabers come on and they actually cycle through the rainbow colors. It's kind of hard to tell at first until you watch it for a few seconds, then you realize they're changing colors. Now, if you want those to stay on all the time without turning off, you can hit it and go one more to the last mode, which is mode 8, and then the lightsabers will cycle through the rainbow colors. You can actually change the duration of how long the motion sensor modes last by hitting the right button. There's 5 different length settings, and if you want it to just run for 5 seconds or so, you can hit it on the lowest setting. If you want it to run for like 25 seconds, you can hit it on the highest setting. Hey, thanks for watching the video. I have to say I'm super excited about the way this turned out. It's kind of a challenging build given it was a first Arduino project and a first LED light strip project that I've done. But anyway, make sure you subscribe, hit the subscribe button. We've got more videos coming up on woodworking, metalworking, and some more electronics and Arduino projects. You can also check out some old videos over here, and make sure you leave some comments down below. I'd love to hear if somebody else has done something like this, or let me know if you have any questions.